Jay's old home, Cameron Indoor. After Duke lost Tuesday night to Illinois, by the way, Illinois ranked higher than Duke in that game, monster squad, Coach K openly questioned whether college basketball should continue to be played amid this pandemic. Listen to Coach K right after the game the other night.
That was made without knowing if there's going to be where the vaccine was, how many cases. Basically, it was more of a mentality of get as many games in as possible. And I would just like, just for the safety, the mental health and the physical health of our players and staff, like to assess where we're at. I know somebody will take what I'm saying tonight and make it like I'm making excuses. I don't make excuses. We need to get a lot better, but for the good of the game and the good of the safety and the mental and physical health of our players and staff and whatever, we need to constantly look at this thing.
I'm glad we played the full clip in its entirety because yesterday, internet trolls, all you see is a snippet of the clip where he just talks about him saying, hey, we need to do something different in college basketball. And people saying he's making excuses. He was not. The first thing he actually said when he came to the podium is that they got their tails whipped by an Illinois team that is a really good team. And he said Duke is not a really good team. Let me give you some context. 177 total games involving at least one Division I team, roughly 20% have been canceled. 177 games. This is where we're at as we're getting towards a spike with COVID-19.
Sounds like an excuse to me. No, I'm just kidding.
You couldn't help yourself. He was waiting on that one. But you know what I'm talking about. You know how people love to jump on top of these things. And I would be the first one to tell you if Coach K didn't own the fact that they got their tails whooped. I watched the damn game. Mm-hmm. I was disappointed in our team too. But I also agree with Coach K at what he said.
No question about it. I totally agree.
No, I was going to say, you know better.
No better than what?
Be listening to them people, man. That's your coach. You know your coach ain't making
no. It just wasn't internet. It turned into like headlines.
No, I
headlines
that,
everywhere.
But you know how I feel when people start, man. I'm not listening to them. Coach, you know Coach K, and you know damn well Coach K ain't making no excuses, no matter what the situation is. That's all I'm saying.
We'll lastly say from a very short basketball perspective, and I'm glad Jay mentioned that, and we did run the quote in full because we do live in a headline society, but just from a pure basketball perspective, Duke did not enroll one player that was in the ESPN top 100, the top 10. Mm-hmm. They rank 100 guys every year from ESPN. They didn't enroll a top 10 guy. And also, Wendell Moore, I don't like to say, he's been a zero.
Agreed.
He's been a total zero.
But by the way,
he's like one of their best players. He's a zero.
I'll tell you that right now. That's not an excuse, though. That's not easy. They got their tails whooped by Illinois. But I will say this. Duke has the resources. All these guys are staying at the Washington Duke inside of a hotel. Really nice facility. Not every D1 has those type of resources in order to help these teams move throughout COVID. So I'm just saying it's getting more and more interesting by the second to watch how these conferences are handling this and how they're adapting on the fly.
What do you make of the fact, just from a different perspective, that Duke is quote-unquote struggling? Kentucky's off to their worst start in 20 years. Kansas is winning games, but barely winning games. They slipped by Creighton, very good program. The other day, they slipped by North Dakota State, not the football team, the basketball team. What do you make of the fact that these blue bloods, even UCLA, Key's fine with UCLA struggling, but a lot of these blue blood squads are really struggling early this year, all collectively.
Turnover rate's too fast in college basketball. It's too fast. I mean, in order to recruit and to stay relevant, you're trying to bring in top 10 recruits, top 20 recruits, but that turnover affects your chemistry each and every year. That's why you have Gonzaga. That's the number one team in the country. That's why you have Iowa and Luka Garza with Jordan Bohannon, the way they play, being a top three team in the country, mm-hmm. because they understand how to play basketball.
And all them teams that you just named will probably wind up being like, when tournament time comes, there in the end.
Yeah, Luka Garza, maybe National Player of the Year. You might not see him go top 20 in the NBA draft.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus right now.